to a little town called Eutaw, Alabama, halfway between Tuscaloosa, Alabama, and Meridian, Mississippi. So we're down close to the Mississippi line, the west end or the west side of what's known as the Black Belt. In the state of Alabama, if they were like plantations, slavery, that kind of thing, this would have been the Black Belt, is where most of that would have been. So there's, like I said, a lot of that tradition down there. It's quite interesting. Every time I get a chance to, revisit it myself.
Lil Jimi Reed, one man blues band. If you're looking for a job, just give me a call. I give you all the blues you can use. Thank you. Have a good day.
How's it going?
Of our roots, and we're reminiscing.
All right.
Right, Tracy?
Right.
Now, you were all about being on the camera.
I'm Johnny Williams, resident of Eutaw, Greene County. We're at the Black Belt Folks Roots Festival, 35th annual. I'm representing the Black Belt Community Foundation, one of the funders of this project. Well, this is one of the earliest blues festivals that were organized in West Alabama. Dr. Zippert started this, like I say, about 35 years ago, primarily as a recognition, especially the local blues and the essence of blues, and Black Belt and roots all fit into the definition of what this is about. Tomorrow is Sunday, and that's gospel music, and that has also been going on for just as long. Blues grew out of the roots of gospel, so it's really fitting that this event is held here on the historic Greene County Courthouse Square, site of major wins and major changes in the civil rights world. So this place is so historic and so deeply rooted in people Oh, that is great to just hear.
Right about Bowler G Way.
Uh-huh.
We're going to bring you Mr. Matt Davis and Miss Peach.
Go on, Miss Miller. Sound man.
I shouldn't have to say I gotta warm up.
All right, here we go.
Hey, y'all! I said, hey, y'all!
Hey.
Yeah, but the rest of y'all didn't say that a while ago. Y'all was just looking at me. You know, when you say hey, you know, somebody said hey back, or huh, or depending on where you're from,
yo.
I'm gonna do it again. Maybe it snuck up on me.
Come on, BJ.
I know for a fact that I distinctly said, hey, y'all! Hey. Hey. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. I want y'all to tell everybody. Tell them that. My name may not be Michelle, but I am definitely in the house.
Well, all right then.
Roll. Oh, let the
You get out about as much out of what you put into me, you get it back. That's if you want to have a good time, you're going to have to put out a little bit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But here's an old one that I'm sure all of you are going to remember. Now, if we're doing a blues song, it takes about three parts. I tell the kids in school when I'm teaching them about blues, and you say, you teach kids about blues? What the hell do you know about blues? You're a white guy. We're from North Alabama, of all things, Sand Mountain, Lord have mercy. Well, I tell them, I say, look, it's just like any other music, except that blues is what started most of the other music. Most of us white guys first got our blues from the old rock and rollers that everybody said was rock and roll, but really they were doing blues music. And here's one of my favorites. Bo Diddy had a farm. On this farm he had some women. Women, hell, women bad. So many women everywhere. The one little cow lived up on the hill, rougher and tougher than a Buffalo Bill. Came up to my house, knocked on the door. She knocked and knocked till her hand got sore. Ooh. Then I heard her go away. This is what I heard her say. She wants a bird. If that mocking bird don't sing, she's gonna want a diamond ring. If that diamond ring don't shine, she's gonna take it to a fire.
Here we go. Hey, my dear. Hey, my dear. Hey, my dear.
Oh, I'm 37 miles of barbed wire. Got a cougar snake on the necktie. Got a brand new house up on the roadside. And made out of a snake hide. Got a brand new chimney up on the roof. Made out of human skull. Won't you take a little walk with me, baby? Now tell me, who do you love? Who do you love? Baby says she wants a bird. Listen, I want to get Shar-Baby to talk to us just for a moment. I've been coming down to this event now for about 4 years, and I was surprised when they allowed me to play, but I would have come anyway because I was fascinated with this event. I'd heard a lot about it. You've been coming here for a little while, too.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me a little bit about
how you got started here. I've been coming here for 4 years. Now, how I got started coming here was through the Willie King Festival. Mm-hmm. See, when I was my first at Freedom Creek, when I first started playing with Willie, somebody, Miss Carol, I got a double job that day. Mm-hmm. See, when I played for Willie, I was just, auditioning for him.
Sure.
So I got a double job that day by Miss Carol and Willie King.
Well, good. So this festival means a lot to you?
Oh, a whole lot.
Oh, yeah. Well, good. Tell me a little bit about this record you're doing in England.
All right. Now, in May of 2010, I ain't been too long come back from Bristol, England. And I did 14 shows over there. And out of those 14 shows, I had 3 sellout crowds.
Good.
And also, Mr. Steve Payne with Digit Doc Records.
Okay.
All right. You can look on the computer and find that www.digitdocrecords. Well, Mr. Steve Payne is going to write me an album. And I got to go back over there 2011 and record it, probably
great.
This spring.
God, that's great. Do you have any recordings available now?
Oh, yes, I do. I've got a CD called Chicago Blues, Alabama Style. And that is on CD Baby, Digidoc Records, iTunes.
Good. I can go there and find you.
All right.
I'm on CD Baby. I love CD Baby.
All right, I love it.
It helps a lot of us that don't really have a lot of distribution, capabilities.
That's right.
But people can find it there anytime if they just go.
That's right. That's true. I love it.
Well, tell me this, and then I'll let you go. I pride myself first being a musician, but one of my other hats is I really love folk life and talking to people about where they came from. So tell me just a little bit about what, I know how you got here now through Willie, but what got you started singing?
What got me started singing? Well, my dad, back in the 60s, 50s, was a gospel.
Uh-huh.
Gospel singer, my dad. That's where I got the singing part from him. And he sung with the Lamb's Quartet, the Revelators. They opened up for the Soul Stirrers, Sam Cooke and the Soul Stirrers. And they also opened up for Dixie Hummingbirds and a whole bunch of other, gospel
Was he
players.
Out of the Bessemer area?
No, my dad is from Martin, Tennessee.
Uh-huh.
But that was a long time ago that he moved to South Bend. I was born in South Bend. So,
I got you.
I understand. So you are a Southerner who went north and then came back.
You got that right, because this is where all the blues is.
You can tell that your roots are here, or at least I think so.
That's
thank
right.
Thank you for talking to me.
And thank you.
All right.
My pleasure.
Hey, baby, we're going to Birmingham. And we're coming on down to Eutaw. Put your hands together for Miss Shar-Baby!
Thank you. Square on a Saturday, like real, like very good.